Omnichannel has been a buzzword extensively used in recent years when it comes to discuss about marketing strategy. Banks have widely embraced the transformation into an omnichannel-based model for corporate and retail banking to different extents across the globe as, let's say, one of the key levers to boost customer experience and ultimately increase profitability. Its adoption dates back to 2010s, and it can be defined as a cross-channel strategy to provide seamless user experience across multiple points of contacts. A typical example is the one of customers who initiate their loan request in the branch and finalize the same on their tablet. At any point in time, clients are able to monitor the progress of their request by checking the approval stages, or also to continue the application process by submitting any needed information remotely and interact with the bank through any available channel, for example, ATMs, ITMs, smartphone, online banking, wearables, tablet, mobile, IoT devices, and so forth. Now, if we look at the opportunities for retail banking in the world, it's actually worth having a look at the distribution of digital customers as they represent the flywheel for the retail omnichannel usage. As of 2019, Europe and Australia have been the market regions with the highest percentage of fully digital customers, around 50%, which are those registering less than 4 branch visits and more than 1 online transaction per year, followed by North America, roughly 40%, Asia, 30%, and South America and the GCC countries, around 10%. The transition into digital-driven behaviors is happening everywhere in the globe, and the COVID-19 pandemic has definitely frustrated behavioral changes. Around 60% of world branches have either closed or shortened their opening hours, introducing fully digital processes by covering typical features such as a digital account opening, remote identification, and verification and contactless payments. Now, in this context of radical transformation, where the old certainties are fading as customers progressively change their behaviors, Omnichannels gives bank the opportunity to build customer journeys based on a tailored channel mix. For instance, some high wealth customers may feel more comfortable to initiate their application online and end it in person with a relationship manager. It means that defining the most suitable customer journey within the omnichannel ecosystem does not entail to drastically discard a physical channel, but rather to strike a balance in the diversification of the channel mix based on targeted customer experience, which will ultimately be the driver to meet the targeted client profitability. While we touched upon the implication for retail banking, it is worth articulating what is occurring for corporates. Looking at the global market, corporate banking offering is really lagging behind retail. Within corporate banking, transaction banking is probably the area which has been mostly affected by digital innovations. For example, its domains covers cash management, trade finance, and supply chain services. But banks have typically struggled to keep pace with fintechs and meet corporate client demands, especially due to the tedious onboarding processes for new facilities, new accounts, inadequate digital surface capabilities, and so forth. For these reasons, corporate are being heavily dependent on physical channels to execute transaction banking activities. The main capabilities include host-to-host transaction between client ERPs and bank system, and authentication option enhancements, virtual accounts, remote check printing, and automated liquidity management processing. All these will support treasurers to focus on core financial management and strategic business priorities. Today's corporate are evaluating their cash management partners, seeking the availability of online and mobile banking tools, which provide streamlined services and faster access to persona-based dashboard while on the move. The expectation from corporate clients is to get prompt decision support and advice given by analytics-driven insight, which with real-time visibility into product portfolio, group structures, transaction statuses, supply chains positions, and so forth. There are significant changes in the regulatory environment that, combined to the digital offerings, are expected to bring interesting business opportunities for corporate banking. The regulatory innovations introduced by the new European Payment Service Directive, which is the PSD2, are driving the orientation of other regulators across the world bringing interesting outlooks for both retail and corporate banking services. So you will be surprised to hear that as far as open banking is concerned, what's at stake for banks is actually more material for corporate services than retail. While banks operate as mere financial information aggregators and tend to provide their services mostly for free in retail, corporates are likely to pay for banking services that will ultimately improve their operational performance. To mention some key capabilities, enterprises can now quickly reconcile their invoices with the transaction occurring on all the other older banking accounts using open APIs. Several ERP providers in Europe have started to integrate banking reconciliation services in their platforms. In this context, treasurers can aggregate the whole corporate liquidity and manage their assets with liquidity and credit monitoring services provided by the banks. To conclude, opportunities offered through the adoption of an omnichannel strategy can be material for both retail and corporate banking. Leveraging transformation with new digital offering is key to succeed, but it is not enough. Data analytics are crucial to understand client behaviors, monitor channel adoption, and eventually support the development of customer journeys that increase profitability and add value to the clients.